Hello guys, one on mission from Autotech, and we are dealing with Toyota Tundra 3-year engine 2010 model. Come closer. The problem that we have here now, the vehicle comes for ordinary maintenance, oil change, spark plugs, etc., brake pads, and it lock up the engine. Now, in this case, to lock up an engine have a lot of reasons and ways to lock. In my own case, it's a little bit more difficult because the vehicle, we drove it inside, we off it, we did the service, and when we try to kick it, to start it, the vehicle don't crank. First thing that we did is to put a booster. Second step, we check the kickstarter, and checking the kickstarter, we turn the crankshaft and we realize that the engine is not turning. Now, it's 50-50 to save this engine. We already did some process. Since yesterday, we put inside a liquid to assist in case of rustiness and anything. Now, cases that engine can lock up. Exists the scenario of shortcut of oil. The symptom from this case is that it's overheating the bearings, and because the metals they are hooking and they are not allowing the crankshaft to turn. Another scenario is from long time, if the vehicle stays without to start, the piston is used to stuck on the cylinder, and again we have the same thing, the engine is locking up. Exists one scenario that because of the small, if you change for instance, because of bad combustion, we have too much carbon on the chamber inside, and when we're removing the injectors and especially spark plugs in this type of engines that you cannot clean. Okay, you can blow here before you can change the spark plug, but if the spark plug already have a carbon on it, it will fall down on the cylinder, and because they are 45 degrees between the piston and the cylinder, usually is entering inside there, and it's not allowing the rotation of the crankshaft. In my own case, when the vehicle came, we noticed a tapping, knocking sound. Because we are very familiar with these engines, we say the oil, actually they overuse the oil, not that the vehicle have overheating, but the oil, it passed the kilometers that, and the vehicle is supposed to make service. We did our own course, and we cleaned the solenoids and etc. Not that the engine is clogging, it's very clean. And we reach here, and what we were trying to do now, in my own case probably, because I have misfire on cylinder 5. This is the bank one, like we say. So, 1, 3, 5, this cylinder have misfire. What is my own belief? This connecting rod probably have clearance. It have clearance, plus the old oil. Now as we remove the oil and the vehicle stay for, because we did some extra body work, it stay almost 4 to 5 days without oil inside. Maybe this is the cylinder that is giving me headache. For me to confirm some things, I just remove the from the camshaft, I release from the drivers to check if my camshafts are turning, consigning the valve, so they are free. And this one also is, where is the, it's back here, this one also is turning. The same thing comes from this side. The same thing is happening here. It's turning from the bank too, and here
also. So, why I did this thing? To verify that we don't have any hook because of the head cylinder. Now, as I shift these things, definitely I change the setting of the adjusters, and especially the main adjusters, because this engine have two chains. One is coming from this bank direct to the crankshaft, and exactly the opposite side, the bank one also. So as we are free from here, we have removed the spark plug. Since yesterday we put inside, actually we put oil and diesel. Of course, if we unstuck the engine, maybe we will break the piston ring. Nobody knows. We need to clean the cylinders and assemble it back and check. Also, another way, in case if we unstuck the engine, we need to run a compression test to make sure that we don't have any broken piston ring. In any case, if we unstuck the engine, we have the availability to check each one cylinder with the diagnostic tools if they are healthy, if we have correct compression and etc. In case that we will see, because I say again that the fifth cylinder, since the vehicle came, I just don't like how operate, but you can't say to the client direct, because doing sometime a service, cleaning the solenoids, cleaning the filters of solenoids, you are stabilizing and from misfire and from the sounds, this regular engine. So now what we will do, we will try to put a bar, and we try, you should please put one bar, we will show that the engine is not rotating also. You put it. Come to show here also. Turn the engine. As you can see, the crankshaft is locked. It's locked up. So now we need to use a rough method that I call. We need to take the big T bar, probably extension, lift a little bit the vehicle and try to unstuck, unlock the engine. Let's try it and we will update. Finally, we try. We remove some components inside here. And no possibility. I don't want to force it more because I will break finally the bolt, and after we will spoil the crankshaft. So now we need to follow up with a repair. The difficult thing is that because the flywheel is not turning, we need to dismantle the half engine inside. And to follow up, to remove the block cylinder. And we will change piston rings, main bearing, and connecting rod bearing. This is the solution in my case. So thank you very much. We'll come back with a new video as we will open the engine and give exactly the faulty side of this regular engine. Exactly what happened inside, because we can't see, we can't do any more visual inspection. We need to go direct operation now.